Change.
Oh, no.
But so we're gonna say happy anniversary. Ready?
Give us a few. What tune? Which virgin we singing?
Yeah.
Which virgin?
We don't go on to two, three, dirty.
Happy anniversary to you. Happy
Uh-huh.
Everybody gonna be in my room.
It's running out.
Since when we
Can we get rid of the car? Everybody's attention. You're gonna read the cards. Okay? Barbara. Tell us a story.
Mama!
Okay. Can you read the cards now?
Read all these cards? Oh, no. I thought you said you were gonna have. Read all these cards. Okay.
All right.
I thought you said we're
going to
do something else first.
Loretta, she's being a baby.
I got you. Okay.
Hey, where else in the room we have to get a mommy king?
With me.
And a virgin.
All right.
You have to get them while you can. And if they come around, you have to take them. When they stop, you're in trouble.
For two wonderful parents. It was only both of you. If only both of you could know how wonderful it has been to have your special love to turn to time and time again. If only you could know how much more you've given day by day, you'd know just why you both are loved in such a special way. Happy anniversary. Love the Greens, Manuel Quinn and Marquise.
All right. Thank you. Yes.
You're not just a wonderful couple. You're a couple of wonderful people. Happy anniversary from Louise and Eugene and Irvin. Guyton. And then it's
right. Thank you.
Okay, here, let me put this back in here. Gwen, somebody help me. Okay. Oh, that goes with me? Okay. Okay, happy anniversary to both of you. Okay, thinking of you on your anniversary, a time to cherish your everlasting relationship and to be thankful for having each other. Happy anniversary to both of you. God bless you, the McGill.
All right.
Thank you.
All right.
I'm gonna put that back because I'm gonna put this back. But you know what? I'm just gonna tell you all. My daddy, I don't know about my mom, but my daddy loves these cards red. So if you buy a card, you've done a good thing. Because the words. God created love between a husband and a wife. So they would give and share and care forever. Happy anniversary. Marshall, Dana, Guyton.
And
they have a token, another token here.
Don't tear it now, you won't get pregnant.
Well.
I'm going to let that out. I'm trying to get some going. Hey, y'all go by Abraham.
You can do that by which one?
Abraham.
Yeah, well.
Sarah and Abraham.
Yeah, y'all go by Abraham and them.
Well, I tell you.
Y'all
not
they are. We may have to preach that.
Oh, is this one?
Yes,
yeah,
right. We're going to pass on this past here.
Oh, this is nice. Let's get it open here. Oh, I love it. I love it. Oh, it's a frame. Mama said, what in there?
I'm like, what's
it?
I'm like,
it's a frame. I love it.
Oh, they got it. Oh, it's one piece.
I love it. Look at it.
See, it's one piece.
You
put it on the wall, but you can put, like, it's like different pictures in there.
Oh,
that's beautiful.
Yeah, that's nice. That stays together.
Uh-huh. And you don't have to worry about trying to get it straight on the wall. It's already straight.
Yeah.
On your anniversary, may you look back on the past with joy, celebrate the present with laughter and love, and anticipate the future with hearts full of hope. Wishing you the best on your special day and always. I always love you, Evangelist Sister Lizada.
All right.
And she has a token of love in there also.
Very nice. We've come all together. Yeah, all right. Thank you so very much.
Okay. Dana.
Yeah.
You lost your job. You're not on your job, baby. No, I put it in here. But you know what? I don't want to get these. They're going to keep them all. Just
okay, but you want to put this back in here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, here. I just made it. I don't want to read this. Okay, for two special parents on your anniversary, there's nothing like the love of parents. There's nothing like the love of parents to make you feel safe and secure, to make you feel that no matter where you go, there's always a place to return to and feel with love, feel a warm light of love. There's nothing like the love of parents to make your heart feel at home. There are so many reasons to thank you, so many reasons to love you, so many reasons to wish you happiness today. Happy anniversary. The Wilson family, headed up by Harry Wilson.
All right.
We love you. Mom and Dad.
Hey, thank you. We need a good meal prepared, too. Yeah.
Okay. Anticipation. The two of you are so very special. It's wonderful knowing a couple like you whose smiles reflect the sunshine along life's way. People like you who care, who inspire, and who share. People who see the bright side, the good side, the light side, the wonderful knowing. It's wonderful knowing a couple like you who add ribbons and roses to life's bouquet. Yeah, happy anniversary from Barbara and Jake Ivy. For you, Mother and Dad, my life is richer, my days are happier because of your example and your love. Because I always felt the security of knowing that you love your family and each other, I find it easier to live and accept you. Because you always encouraged me to do my best and gave me the freedom to follow my heart, I find it easier to accept others without judging. Because I had your example of appreciating the good in all people and in all creation, I find it easier to discover joy in every circumstance and surrounding. Together, you have added so much love and happiness to my journey through this life that I can't thank you enough. On your anniversary, I want to let you both know how much you really mean to me. Happy anniversary. Love, Shirley and Janelle.
Wow.
Love right. Is so good. What is a soulmate? Okay. If you have found a smile that is the sweetest one you've known, if you have heard within a voice the echoes of your own, if you have felt a touch that stirs the longings in your heart, and still can find the closeness in the moments that you're apart. If you have filled with wonder at the way two lives can blend to weave a perfect pattern that is seamless end to end, if you believe some things in life are simply meant to be, then you have found your soulmate, your heart's own destiny. There they are, right there.
All right.
Soulmate. Thinking of you is in a very special way, not just on this beautiful occasion, but often as the days go by. Happy anniversary, for love, Deborah Reddy. Now you can take that off, and that's like a little keepsake. You can keep like a little credit card. You can take it with you. That's wonderful.
All right.
Okay, and moving right along here. Such a joyous occasion. On your anniversary with love, what are grandparents? They're people who care, who comfort and listen, and thoughtfully share, who do little things that they hope will delight, who try very hard to make every day right. They're all around special and lovable too. That is if their grandparents are exactly like you. Hope your anniversary is just as special as you are. Happy anniversary from your grandchildren, Arnett and CJ.
All right.
That's nice. Well, they are. I don't know. Okay, this is beautiful. To a favorite couple on their anniversary. Some couples are meant to find a rare and special joy in the life they live together, to share a love unlike any other, and to commit to a marriage built on trust, understanding, friendship, and respect. Because you've always been one of those couples, you and your marriage are an inspiration to others and a constant reminder that true love doesn't just happen, it's made over time. Hope you always know how special you are.
We can preach on this one.
Yay! We can preach. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, maybe I should. Hope you always know how special two of you are and how much happiness you wish on your anniversary always. Love, Oscar, Junior, Pat, and CJ.
All right.
How many of you know? I said, how many of you know that love don't just happen?
It just don't happen.
True love don't just happen. That a marriage can be an inspiration to others.
Yes, it can.
Inspiration.
Okay.
Constant reminder. Happy anniversary, true lovers. They're the ones who know how to make love last. Who can look in the future
and learn from the past.
walking hand in hand, who can speak without words and still understand.
All right, understand.
They're the ones who look for the positive, who believe in each other and know how to give. They're the ones whose joy shines in their eyes. And who have gone through the fire and can testify.
Testify.
Okay. And then when all else fails, they can look deep within
and always find true love.
True love again. Over and over again. Never gets old. Just like the river. Just over and over. Okay, wish you many, many years of finding happiness and love with each other. Love the Bryants.
Don't just watch me sit and mess up a car.
Keila, Joe, Cameron, Kyra.
That was you.
Cameron.
Stacy.
Yeah, that's
beautiful.
Right.
Okay. All right. All right, now that's I think beautiful. We're going to have.
That's beautiful. Beautiful.
We're going to have a dedication for the children.
Okay, let's quit. Well, then I have a little song.
Where is it?
It's going to take that long to get on the chair.
No,
where is it? Jay, are we ready for you?
Can I take a picture?
She's in my bedroom.
Hey,
I told you they're finished.
We're gonna have Jaya. Every year we have an anniversary. Jaya always sings.
Yeah.
Let's go back to the 40th anniversary. Remember, she sang the first time. And there was only one time, I think, between that time she didn't sing, and that was because she was away at school. And I think I dropped the ball at that time because she did record a song, but I didn't get it. I didn't put it on the tape to let it be heard. So anyway, Jaya will come in her own way.
First of all, I want to say happy anniversary to Grandma, Grandpa, and then I love you both very much. One thing that I want to say about Grandma and Grandpa is that they've always given what they've had to the family. They've given 100%. And a lot of people think that in order to let God use them, they have to have a whole lot of money or a whole lot of talent or a whole lot of this and that. But the thing about Grandma and Grandpa is they've given what they had. And when God uses what you give, when you give it out of a genuine heart, it becomes this beautiful thing that is just a testimony that the whole world can see. And that's how Grandma and Grandpa have just set an example for this entire family. And so for that, I am truly grateful. And the song that I'm going to sing is a song that you've heard me sing before. But it's a song that's dear to my heart, and it kind of represents how Grandma and Grandpa have lived their life and how God has been able to use them through the love that they've given. And the name of the song is Ordinary People.
Ordinary people, my God uses ordinary people. He chooses people just like me and you who are willing to do as He commands. God
Church, and I guess I was about, I'm thinking I was about maybe 15 years old, and Clifton was maybe 16 or 17, and Clifton, he came to me and he said, Oscar, you know, the people that I was staying with, my relatives, he said, I don't have a place to stay. He said, you know, I don't know what to do. I said, well, why don't you just come home with us, and you know, eat dinner, you know, because I know mom and dad, they always had an open house to, you know, let people come home to eat. And so he came home, and he ate dinner with us. And during that time, he told dad, you know, what he had told me. And dad told him at the time, and he said, son, as long as you need a place to stay, you got a place here. And so Clifton became part of our family at that time. And he was just one of the people. I mean, I had uncles, I had cousins, and just different other people that I've just seen mom and dad take in. And so we've always seen the love that they had. I mean, it's extended further than just us. And so, you know, like at this particular point in our lives, when we look back, a lot of things we didn't understand at the time, but we see the love that mom and dad, They gave of themselves. And so any accolades that they get now is well deserved. Amen. So I want to thank all the family and friends who came out today to help celebrate mom and dad's 59th wedding anniversary. And that's a long time. I said 59 years. I mean, that must be close to that somewhere along there. So that's some years. So I want to, at this time, on behalf of sisters and brothers, I'd like to make a presentation of a gift that we give every year. But before I say that, I want to mention that Philip, my baby brother Philip, he wanted to be part. So he sent in a contribution, and he really wanted to be here, but he couldn't make it today for some other reasons. And so he told me to be sure to tell mom and dad a happy anniversary for him from his family. Also, Clifton Talbert, which is the one I just mentioned, he's part of the family, and he said to me that to be sure to tell mom and dad happy anniversary. And he told me, he said, make sure they know, and Barbara was in the background, his wife. He said, make sure they know that we would have been here to the gathering if only Barbara didn't mind flying. He said, Barbara was afraid of flying. He said, if she didn't mind flying, we would be there. So, but he said he wanted to make sure that you all know, you mom and dad know that that his family is wishing you a happy 59th wedding anniversary. So at this particular time, see a card. At this particular time, from the sisters and brothers, that's all of us, we want to give mom and dad a gift of our $700.
Thank you so much.
Another card here. For a special couple on your wedding anniversary. Marriage is a promise to communicate and share, to treat each other with respect, to listen and to care. Marriage is commitment by a husband and a wife to be each other's lover, friends, confidant, and wife. All the special times you have shared in your marriage have led up to the joy you feel today, and everyone who knows you can see how much you care for each other. So may this joy you have found and your love continue to grow, and may all your future days be especially wonderful. Congratulations. Happy anniversary to Edward, Jay, Adrian, and Sophia.
Hey!
All right. Edward, Jaya, Sophia, Sophia, three of them.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
Did I say it right, Sophia? Is it Sophia?
I got to learn that name. Later.
Sophia Marie, right?
Okay, there you go.
All right.
I'll give you a
benefit. Allow me to say something.
Yeah, we'll allow you.
All right, well, you know what? I'm enjoying myself, but I just want to say, I think all of y'all for coming, every one of y'all is special. If I take time, each person here I tell them is, and get some good conversation and good things that is helpful. But I want to especially thank the ones that come because they was asked and they didn't let us down. So I really appreciate that, because I a lot of times you ask people, they don't care to fool with you. They don't care to, you know, fellowship with you. So I learned these things from being what I am. I can't be nothing but what I am. So like that song by said, let the life that I live speak for me. That's the kind of life I try to live. And my wife, along with her, I never left her a day since we've been married on the kind of we were mad with one another. I never stayed away a night on the kind of we were mad with one another. Couldn't. But another thing about her, I'm going to say something about her. She have she have lived a life that you could say a mother of a church, because all the things that I read in the Bible and all the things that she have did.
Right.
And so I appreciate her, but I appreciate my daughters and my son-in-laws and daughter-in-laws. I don't see why they don't make a difference. They just like mine, either one of them. I come to them for anything. I don't feel not a one of them would deny me, because they just that kind of love for me. So I appreciate that, because that don't just happen often either.
Right. Yeah.
And so I know it may be some little fine print there, you know, when you're getting things together like this, but I take the whole thing as a bouquet of love. And we got a lot of talent in our group too, because we got some here, and our sister Lasada sang a good song. Pat, she's a teacher, preacher, and the song. So, and yeah, she does pretty much.
Yeah.
But now, I just want to say, I don't have the words to say, but I thank God for getting this far, that I can say I've been with my wife for 59 years. And so I don't feel too bad myself. I don't have no arthritis. I don't have no hates in my joints of no kind. And I don't have no knee problem. I don't have no ankle problem. I don't have no hip problem.
That's a blessing.
What I told Loretta today, when I wake up in the morning, I find myself, I do be hurting. That's a sign he ain't dead. So we love you all, and we try to be what we should be. And my wife, she always was a good teacher, and she's a missionary. I'm a deacon. Sometimes we get together with some things we have to kind of iron out.
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes she got a lot of knowledge and I got a little wisdom, and mm-hmm. we put it together. And we have a good time at home sometimes. So we appreciate for our children that living with us. We don't have no can no gun at one another. And I never, this is another thing I want to say to my children. I never had to get one out of jail. I never had to worry with one by no dope or nothing. I never know nothing like that. And I never know none of the things that, you know, a lot of people have experienced. But I don't say we did all we could, but we did the best we could, because it was a learning experience when you're raising children. You can't do what we did then like today, because a lot of things have changed. A lot of things that people think they could do like they did years ago, but the things have changed. You just can't do it. You have to do it in another way. So I just thank God for you all, and thank you for your time and patience to be out. Now my sister-in-law, boy, she stick by us over there. And now my two secretaries, they wise, they came out to be with us, and all our grandchildren and friends and loved ones, I really appreciate everything, so I think I done said enough.
Amen.
Thank you.
Well, I would like to say praise the Lord and thank God for his goodness and mercy to me. I can say, I look back over my life, and I think things over.
Yes.
God has been good to me. I have had many afflictions, sickness, but he kept me for this day. And I thank God for my children, which I thought I would never marry. I thought I would never have children. I came from a real broke-up home. But I thank God that he let us get married, and in my mind it wasn't going to work, and I was thinking it wasn't going to work. But God bless him, when I got to the point I thought it wasn't going to work, I thought, well, I'll break it up now before it get too far. But God saved me before that happened. And having children and things that wasn't much money, wasn't much this, and we came from the South, and we didn't have any friends here. Nobody was willing to help or nothing. We were just by ourselves. But I thank God when we used to have service back, what they call grove meetings up on them trees out there when it was too hot. We didn't have air conditioning. Too hot to be in church, we'd get out of the tree. And them old people used to sit there God is a good God. He is a present help in a time of trouble. And one day I said to the Lord, I said, I've heard them say that. And I said, Lord, I'm in trouble. I'm married, got these children, I don't know what to do. But God put it in my heart, on my heart, to read the Bible. And from reading the Bible up tonight, God saved me. And that was a little rough then, but then God saved him. And our life has been beautiful. And I thank God for my children. They are beautiful. They are beautiful. They were children and coming up and first time raising children. Now, if I had to do it again, I'd probably look back and do it a little better. But I know I did some things that they didn't like, and they, you know, just coming up together. But I thank God that God has kept us together, and we have looked over mistakes was made and bringing it up and everything, and they still love me, and I love and appreciate them. And I not bragging, but I like to say that I got some of the best children in the townhouse. That used to, I used to tell them, the girls, I had the best girls in the townhouse. And they was happy about that. But then one day they got up loud enough to wonder what the townhouse was. And when they asked what the townhouse was, I think they were disappointed. They were thinking, but I told them the deep place down in my heart. But they were looking for some place, somewhere that they were the beautiful children over in there. But it was some inspiration to them. You know, God gives you a small way of doing small things. And in the end, they can turn out big. And I want to thank all y'all for coming. I don't feel important just to be a person, but y'all just make me feel like I'm somebody. And I just love you all. And I hope whatever I've done in the future that I can continue on until the Lord comes, that someone can see that God has blessed me and I have tried to be a blessing. So thank you all for coming. I love you all.
Yes, Sister Ruth, I want to hear what you got to say. You are a friend. You might want to say.
I don't want to say that I want both of you to know that we feel privileged to have been invited to celebrate an anniversary for such a couple of you. And I want you to know that you all have been an inspiration in my life. And your children are the most respected children that I've ever met. I want you to know you did a good job, Deacon and Sister Guyton, in raising those kids in the townhouse. and thank you again for inviting us, and we want you to know it's a privilege to be here. We don't want you to forget us next time.
All right. You hear that? That sure is our ongoing thing. We got love. But let me tell you one little hidden thing in raising the trap, because we didn't have right communication. My daughter was wrapped and twin. They wanted to do something for Mama. I think it was Thursday or something. So they went to something to Mama's woman there. They stayed a little too long. But see, Mama didn't know. They didn't want Mama to know what they were doing. They just wanted to get some presents for her. And they didn't tell me. I didn't know. So when they did come back, they got a hook. And that made me feel so bad. That made me mad that they were doing something for her. And then got a hook. See, I should have known. I should have.
But that's all part of being raised.
I know he's so bad. That was one of her things.
Like the cat, get into a dripping in blood.
Yeah, that was something.
but we waited.
All right. We,
but what it was, they were supposed to come back and help me in the stove. You know, because I was just waiting, trying to wait on people. And they upset me.
Yeah.
You know, and I told them not to stay long, and they said, you know.
We've been trying to get, you know, spend the time with the kids.
But no, it's a challenge.
Yes, yes. If you shop and you kind of lose track of time, you do.
Coming back.
Okay. He's in the bathroom. Okay. Anybody want to say anything?
You want to say something? You want to say something? No, you don't have to.
I just want to say that it's an honor to be invited, and I appreciate you, and I love you, and you have some real good kids. You've done a terrific job. I don't know of any other family treat their parents like you do. And that's an honor within itself. So you have something to really be proud of.
All right.
Well, I'd like to say that we certainly feel special to be invited to this occasion. It's quite an occasion of 59 years. Pretty good time. And to have known Deacon and Sister Guyton all these years. From the first time we came to St. Louis, the first time I came to St. Louis, 1982, they both have been an inspiration to me. And to be invited, I looked around. I didn't see one other church member, and other than my counterpart, Deacon McGill, I didn't see no other deacons here. So we certainly, I know I feel privileged to be invited and blessed to be a part of this family. So I feel like I'm an extended, part of the extended family of the Guyton. And so we've been knowing for a while, and all of our relationships have been good. And Deacon Guyton is certainly been helpful, not only inspiration, but helpful to me. A lot of practical things that I need to know in terms of how to do things and all. Call Deacon Guyton and usually he'll give me that answer. Or he'll come out and I did have him, I always tell this, I told him that I would hire him to help me do a fence, put a fence around my house. And I looked up and I was doing all the work and Deacon Guyton was doing all the instructing. But I learned something. I learned something. So. We always have a good relationship, and hopefully it'll continue in the future, and I'm sure it will. So thanks a lot for everything you've done for us too.
All right.
And
that's beautiful. I know Barbara won and forgot some of her things. Yeah, she said
thing. I said us.
They don't know who us is. Us is me. I've been a part of this family since I was, how old were we, Oscar? 15, 14, 12, 14 years old. And it's just like Oscar would say, we can feel free to go to their house, and just felt a part of the family. So I feel a part of the extended family, and I just appreciate them including my husband and I in this day.
Thank you. That's beautiful. That's beautiful.
Well, I didn't come around when you were real young, but come around all the time now. I used to always come around Deacon and Sister Guyton and sit there and talk and learn a lot. And true, I cannot believe all the things Deacon Guyton can do. He doesn't have a handicap. He just has, he can do amazing. He put up fences and fixed up a house. And he's done a lot of things. He's been a true friend. And we certainly appreciate him and love him. And, appreciate being invited to this auspicious occasion. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Mom, those are your flowers.
Thank you.
Yeah,
they are beautiful.
Okay, in closing, One thing I forgot to do, though, I forgot to really thank you all for coming. The ones that I call, I forgot to thank you all, because it's really nice when you ask someone to come to something and they come. You know,
Thank you for your excellent direction.
Well, I got a website, but I also told. But anyway, I want to thank everybody. And I always say, I have guests, I have special guests, I have special, special guests, and I have special, special guests. So, my mom is a special guest. She's a family guest, she's a special guest. The last time LaSalle was a special, special guest. This time she's a special, special guest. And our family special guest, the student family, is Jake and Ivy.
Y'all stole my cousin, Debbie. We didn't steal nothing. Well, we didn't steal nothing. Anyway, we paid for them blood.
So Debbie and I are the first
cousin. And our special, special guest this time, three times, is the McGills. And I also want to thank Lil T for coming. I just want to really thank Lil T. That's our backbone.
I just want to say, you know, a long time ago, when I didn't know too many people at Lively Stone, and I was in trouble, and Sister Guyton come over there and said, I don't want you to hang your head because so you hold your head up and keep on going. And I thought, Lord, I sure needed that. And, you know, Sister Guyton has just been right there, and I really appreciate that.
Thank you. That's beautiful. All right, let's keep
it. Well, I just want to say I appreciate being invited, and I probably have known longer than anybody. I was just listening to see what they were going to say. But I'm sure that I've known longer than anybody. And they have, you know, they're a wonderful couple. They got wonderful children. And they all down. See, I'm a sister-in-law. Yeah, I'm a sister. But anyway, and it's just nice. It's just nice when you can get family together. And the children all have turned out so good. And we just have so much to be thankful for. Just say our many, many more.
Thank you.
She's been a true sister-in-law. She really did an excellent job, my brother, down in this time. She really was there all the way. And I really thank her for being that type of sister-in-law.
Well, you have to do what you have to do.
Thank you.
Yeah.